tonight we've proven once again that Western New York's voice has been heard in Albany, a voice that for far too long has been ignored. While much of the final days of the legislative session has centered around mayoral control in New York City and a rent control agreement, the final package passed by both houses tonight shows that substantial help is also on the way for hardworking middle-class families in Buffalo, Cheektowaga, Lackawanna, and all of Western New York and upstate. With $3.1 billion in property tax relief coming to upstate homeowners, the support taxpayers have been waiting on for years is finally within sight. New Yorkers currently pay some of the highest property taxes in the entire nation, putting homeownership out of the reach of many working families. In Western New York, property taxes are squeezing the budget of local families, threatening to price them out of their homes and push them out of our region and our state, and endangering the economic comeback that we're all fighting so hard for. The statistics are staggering. Since 1977, New York's had the highest combined state and local tax burden in the nation for every year but three. New York is sadly home to the highest tax counties in the nation. On average, New Yorkers pay approximately $54 for every $1,000 of personal income in property taxes. That's a whopping 56% above the national average. These statistics must change, and it starts tonight. With the passage of this bill in my district, the town of Cheektowaga, for example, a family with a household income of $75,000 is looking at an additional $185 in their pocket in 2016. In 2019, it goes up to $430. That's real money. That's money that's going to be fed right back into the local economy. And it's going to help middle-class families make ends meet. With this agreement, we're fulfilling our commitment to Western New York families who've been overtaxed for far too long. We're taking a major step in the right direction and providing much-needed tax relief to working families across the state. It's about time that we do so. And while I look around and I hear the passionate pleas of colleagues on both sides of the aisle, while they're supporting this bill and while they're not supporting this bill, Mr. President, I have 3.1 billion reasons why I'm supporting this bill. I will vote aye, Mr. President.